So the Petrified Forest, it's a unique window into the Late Triassic period. And this year they found this piece of armor bone from an animal called an adasaur, so from one of these adasaurs. Now these are skin plates, so these are bones that form inside the skin and create armor plating along the backs of these animals. They're called osteoderms. These are really neat because when we find the patterning on these, we can actually identify them down to a species. So it's almost like a fingerprint in a way.
We opened up the protective plaster jacket here in the lab, exposed the bone that we saw in the field, prepared it, meaning separating the bone from the rock, clearing the rock and mudstone away.
We have probably about 20 different osteoderms in the collection from several different species. And so as you go through time in the rocks at Petrified Forest, the different species that are around change. And so part of what the use of the fossils are is actually to tell time. The rocks at Petrified Forest are roughly 205 to 225 million years old. And so that's about the age of the fossils that we see. This is the Late Triassic time period.
Most of what's in this particular locality are quite small. So it's kind of hands and knees, face almost into the ground, poking with a little tool, scraping away dirt and seeing if you can find a bone.
The quarry is a really difficult place to work because even though we have these really spectacularly small bones, you almost never see them until you break them. You'll find a bone by breaking it, and then you have to be able to put it back into its spot and then go around it and excavate the entire thing very, very carefully. I'm really excited that the quarry is producing these new species because it expands our understanding of what was happening about 215 million years ago. The more information we have about why this particular group of reptiles became so important is important for our understanding of evolution.